Okay, so introduction to urban gardening. So urban gardening, it is the practice of growing food in cities, and also it encompasses various methods such as container, including community gardens. So here are the objectives. First is to be equipped with basic knowledge on urban gardening, and to determine the essentials in engaging on urban gardening, and to identify the benefits one will get from urban gardening, and to know the proper steps, of course, in seed sowing and creating a sap garden, and of course to be aware on the history of urban gardening here in the Philippines. So here are the presentation outline. The first is the background. Define urban agriculture or history, urban garden characteristics, and who is the garden urban gardener, and urban gardening essential as well. So challenges and benefits of urban gardening, and different system of urban gardening, and types of urban gardening in the Philippines. So the first is the background. So more than 50% of the world's population lives in the cities. So over 800 million people worldwide depend on food grown in cities. So around 15% of the world food is grown in unurban areas. So low-income urban dwellers spend between 40% and 60% of their income on food each year. So the history of urban gardening in the Philippines, so it started to use under the governance of President Joseph Estrada in 1998. So the First Lady, Loy Ejercito, initiated a program which is the combined agriculture or mixed farming. So under supervision of the office of the Presidential Assistant for Food. So after 2 years, the program has launched 30 vegetable gardens with cumulative area of around 230,000 square meters. So the program has 2,500 beneficiaries. So the Department of Agriculture became the program's implementing agency under President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. So by the way, what is urban agriculture? So according to East West, so urban agriculture is the practice of growing and cultivating food in densely populated areas for personal consumption by the grower or for distribution to the inhabitants located in close proximity to where food was grown. It is also the process of growing plants in an urban environment. And of course, it has several unique gardening concepts to include the what we call container gardening, including the indoor gardening. So here are the urban garden characteristics. So has limited space to grow crops, so at least or below 50%, 50 square meters area. And of course, to use of organic or simply the natural inputs and available spaces at home. So to include the rooftop hand railings, balcony or patio walls, window sill boxes, and alongside of the house, and including fence. So who is the urban gardener? So people who live in residential or real estate. Condo unit owners, apartment tenants, and the office building management. So including community in the city, those who are engaged also in social enterprises, and of course, hobbyists, one who has a passion in growing crops. So anybody can do urban gardening. So provided that you have a passion to grow crops. or any kind of commodities.
Oh,
so uh, urban gardening essential. So the first one is sunlight. So full exposure is not always required, because some plants like salad greens, including ginger, need only indirect exposure by way of window, or it can be in the shade. So in the case of water, the amount varies depending on the plant as well. So in the case of compost, choose a method that works for you. Gather your trash, then as much as possible, you may add bokashi bran, indigenous microorganism, including fermented plant juice, or seek the help of the black soldier flies, for their, including the vermicast, the cast of an earthworm, specifically the African night crawler. So in the case of seeds or cutting, so of course, depending on the preference of the grower. So a working hand, be willing to get hands stained with dirt. Don't give up easily. No one has a green thumb. And the reward is when you finally see something grow. So urban gardening. So access to land and or area to start urban gardening. Access to water as well, because we know very well that water is necessary in putting up urban gardening. So management of soil fertility or cost of good quality of soil for containers. And of course, availability of cost of inputs in a very small packaging, seeds or seedlings. And at the same time, limited knowledge in growing seed, growing vegetables, and community involvement and acceptance to avoid a theft of vegetables, for example. So factors to be considered in urban gardening. So the first one is drainage. So in the case of drainage, considering drainage in urban gardening is essential for ensuring plant health, managing water effectively, and promoting sustainable gardening practices. So the next one is air movement. Sufficient air movement prevents water lagging and diseases. Too much wind is also not good. Wind burns leaves dry out and breaks, especially in the rooftops. That's why, if that is the case, you may put a makeshift that will serve as a windbreak. So in the case of the soil media, so soil media is crucial in urban gardening for a nutrient availability, to include moisture management and root aeration as well, while mitigating contamination risk and supporting beneficial microorganism, ensuring healthy, productive garden and the safe food as well. Okay, in the case of the container size, of course, depending on the plants that we're going to raise or to grow. And the case of the viability of seeds, it is very important that we need to consider that the seeds to be planted, to be so is viable seeds. So the water, in terms of water requirement, so we need to maintain a good soil moisture level. So as much as possible, water early in the morning and if needed in the afternoon. So water deeply and thoroughly until some water comes out from the drainage holes of a certain container. So generally, plants in containers dry more easily. That's why they need to be watered. So raise containers at least 1 to 2 inches above ground when in the case of the patios, a balcony, or in the case of concrete floors to drain well. So which plant to grow given the limited sun in an urban area. So here are the type of sun or shade. So the first one is mostly sun, so around 6 hours or more of direct sun. So what are the plants that that can thrive? So solanaceous. So what are the solanaceous? To enumerate some is the are the eggplant, tomatoes as well, including pepper, and most cucurbit crops. So how about in the case of the partly sun or partly shade? So at least 4 to 6 hours of sun. So most herbs, brassicas, lettuce, cucumber, bush beans, root veggies such as carrot, radish, and potatoes, to include garlic and ginger. So in the case of the mostly shade, so at least 3 to 4 hours of sun. So here are the plants that thrive on the mostly shade. Are the following: mustard, spinach, arugula, pak choy, garlic, mint, chives, including parsley. So plant medium. So important characteristics of potting medium. So it has at least it has a good water holding capacity and aeration. It has the capacity, of course, to supply nutrients to the plant, and of course it is very important to consider that the medium that we are going to make use is free from soil-borne diseases. And here are the sample of potting medium mixes. So the first one is one part of sheepskin, one part of garden soil, and one part of compost. And the second one is 6 parts of carbonized rice hull, 2 parts of garden soil, 1 part of compost, and of course, 1 part of sheepskin. And the third one is 1 part of coco cuerdas, 1 part of garden soil, and 1 part of compost. So in the case of the potting medium, so depending on the availability of the media that we're going to use. So container size and soil requirement of vegetables. So starting with eggplant, so at least the minimum container size or the soil requirement is at least 5 gallons. So around 37, more than 37 kilos of soil. And distance per plant in container, so one plant per container. So in the case of the container depth, so at least 10 inches. So in the case of the bell pepper, 5 gallon for the minimum container size, one plant per container, and at least 8 inches in terms of container depth. And in the case of the tomatoes, 5 gallon and one plant per container, and 12 to 18 inches in terms of the container depth, and many more. So in the case of the seeds, of course, use quality seeds. Example of the quality seeds is like hybrid seeds, to include open pollinated variety, or simply yung OPB, and of course the indigenous crops. So hybrid seeds have value adding characteristic that are either resistant or tolerant to a certain pest and plant diseases. If not yet consumed, of course, in the case of the seeds that it's excess, so as much as possible we need to put the excess seeds in a container, then keep in a cool, dry place, or any container may do. So reasons and perceptions. So fruits and vegetables are expensive. So vegetables are seasonal, take long to prepare. Fruits and vegetables spoil quickly, and the fruits and vegetable contain harmful pesticides. And urban gardening, here are the benefits. So in terms of health, so access to safe and quality food, and of course, food security within households. So in the case of the social, poverty alleviation and social integration. So physical activity provides education function. So in the case of the economical, so save household expenditures, and of course, it may serve as an additional source of an income. So in the case of the ecological, greening and cleaning of city, waste reduction, and reduce, of course, the methane emissions, and reduce urban temperature and carbon footprint. So contribute also to disaster risk reduction. So here are the 7 tips for urban gardening. So the first one is we need to define the space, or define your space. Pick your pot, choose your plant that you're going to grow or you're going to plant. And put soil and in your pot, of course, using a good source of soil media. So using seed, or it can be a seedling. So good watering system is very important also. So here are the what is recyclable material. So one of the most important aspect of container farming is finding alternative uses for household items. So which were thrown out in the garbage as non-biodegradable wastes product will help lessen pollution. That's why instead of throwing them in a garbage, we can make use as an alternative material that we're going to use as a container in urban gardening. So here are the examples. So recycled tin can. So as you can see on the presentation, the tin cans are planted with the different plants. So planted with chives, planted with the mint as well, and including planted with oregano. And any kinds of plant may do. So recycled plastic bottles. So it can be the plastic bottle of used mineral water, including a plastic bottle of soda or soft drinks. So next is old tires for vegetable farming. So instead of throwing them, instead of burning them, instead of piling them in a certain area, so we can make use as an alternative material in growing some kind of crops. As you can see on the illustration, a tire plant planted with an eggplant, a lettuce, including radish. So all genes also can be used in an urban gardening. So instead of burning them, or instead of we can use as a medium in planting. So provided that you're going to put or load a good source of a soil medium or soil media. So as you can see on the illustration, an old jeans planted with a tomato, planted with an onion, and planted with a radish. So bamboo pots can do also. So here in the Philippines, so bamboo pots is locally available. So we can use as a medium in urban. As you can see also, bamboo pole, they use bamboo pole as an alternative of PVC in the case of the hydroponic gardening, as you can see on the illustration. So next is wooden vegetable pot or boxes. So next is coconut husk. So instead of throwing them, instead of burning them, so we can make use in hanging garden. So the different systems of urban gardening. So starting with the rooftop garden. So in case of building or individual house, as you can see on the illustration. So we can actually produce, or we can actually raise or grow different kinds of vegetables using this rooftop garden. So provided that you have a rooftop, so you can grow. So next is balcony garden. So in the case of the condo and the apartment. So open field gardening in urban area, so community and individual piece of land. So next is roadside gardening, a public space in an urban area, community managed. So as you can see on the illustration, they planted rice and different kinds of vegetables. So on the upper right side, the presentation, they use sap gardening. So around the house may do using containers or in beds as well. So next is the hydroponic system. So it can be for families or it can be for commercial. So in the case of the vertical gardening, so this is suited for areas with concrete flooring, more efficient use of its space compared to planting, of course, direct to ground. So container, common for people with small patios, yard, or balconies. Container gardening make use of a variety of containers. So the empty plastic bottle, the unused boxes can also utilize in this kind of container gardening. So community gardening, this is a method of using outdoor public or space to cultivate gardens for food or pleasure as a group, and it's a great choice for those with no yard or outdoor space. And here are some of the benefits of community gardening. So starting with community organizing, the crime prevention, cultural opportunities for youth, and the most important thing is the case of the food production. So indoor gardening, this is the type of urban gardening where you can grow plants in container, or it can be in pot indoors. So an artificial or natural lighting can be used in this type of gardening. So different vegetables suited for urban gardening. So starting with leafy vegetables. So examples are pechay, lettuce, cabbage, mustard, sweet potato tops, kangkong. So in the case of the Malabar spinach, for the case of the alugbati, and including spinach. So the next one is root or bulb crop. So as you can see on the illustration, here are the examples. So onion, radish, garlic, carrot, sweet potato, and turnip. So the third one is beans, string beans, mung beans, and including winged bean, provided that in the case of the string beans and winged bean, you need to have a trellis, especially in the case of the viney plant. So fruit vegetable example are the following: eggplant, tomato, okra and to include sweet pepper or bell pepper. So flower vegetables, cauliflower including broccoli. So vine fruits, vegetable, squash, cucumber, bitter gourd, sponge gourd, rich gourd including sayote. So herbs, example, thyme, basil, oregano, and of course, rosemary. So here are the methods of sowing vegetables. So the first one is direct seeds. So vegetables that are directly seeded are the following. So to include radish, sugar beets, carrots, okra, papaya, beans, cucumber, battle gourd, squash, bitter gourd, watermelon, melon, and of course the winter melon. So transplant seedlings at 2 to 3 weeks after seedlings have been germinated. So transplant late in the afternoon to prevent what we call transplanting shock, and at the same time to, of course, to speed up the recovery of the newly transplanted seedlings. So the process of transplanting, transferring the seedlings in the seed cup thoroughly, and of course to choose a potting container large enough to accommodate the full grown plant. So watering, so the ideal time to water the plant is from 9 o'clock in the morning. So if the water is not too hot, so at least you need to water once a day. But if the weather is too hot, so water twice a day. So in the morning and in the afternoon. So weeding, cultivate the soil to allow air to enter the potting medium and encourages bigger and healthier roots for the plant. So as much as possible, cultivate only around the perimeter of the plant's outer leaves with a depth of 5 to 7.5 centimeter below the soil level to prevent from disturbing the deeper root system of the plant. So in the case of the fertilization, so use of organic fertilizer like rice wash, including concoction to include fermented plant juice, fermented fruit juice, including indigenous microorganism to promote healthy ecosystem and produce healthy foods. So harvest plants at the right maturity age. So as long as the plants reach already the what we call the physiological maturity. So a rule of thumb, harvest early in the morning or it can be late in the afternoon. So in the case of vegetable or it can be in the case of the fruit, so right before cooking or eating to retain the sugar content. So before cooking or eating to retain the sugar content, so it's the time that you're going to harvest the said vegetables and fruits. And for the case of the leafy vegetable like pechay, lettuce, so harvest first the lower leaves. So this kind or this method of harvesting the first lower leaves is what we call priming. So according to Crop Life, so once in your life you need a doctor, a lawyer, a policeman, a preacher, but every day, 3 times a day, you need a farmer. So here are the references. So that's all, and thank you so much for listening.